Hey YouTubers, it's Firefighter K1. Welcome to another video and spotlighting the embodiment of rock singer Roy Orbison. This time around, we're going into 1966. We're going to begin a series of video episodes spotlighting Roy's embodiment of music for MGM Records. Roy left Monument in July of 1965, and he signed a 20-year deal with MGM Records in hopes of becoming a movie star, the contract of $1 million, and much, much more. So strap in, sit back, and relax, and we're going to begin with Roy's second album from 1966, The Orbison Way. Right away, you're probably thinking, wow, you overlooked an album there, Firefighter Juan, and there is only one Roy Orbison. We spotlighted that entire album collection review back in episode 11. So if you want to go back, check out the video. We spotlighted that in an earlier episode by request. We also, by popular demand, wanted to see some of the singles that came out after Pretty Woman was released in 1964. So there is only one Roy Orbison, was not skipped over. Again, it is episode 11 in the series. But we are up to episode 19. We are going to be taking a look at Roy's second album release from the MGM years, titled The Orbison Way. It was a good hit. Roy's continuation on the charts continued into 1966. The album went to 128 in the US and number 11 in the UK. Before we dive into spotlighting The Orbison Way, let's go back 1 year to 1965. Let's briefly talk about There Is Only One Roy Orbison. Roy's fan base in 1965 were very concerned that the sound was going to continue, the ballads, the rock ballads, Roy's hand in the songs and the albums that were going to be released. They were concerned that Roy was not going to be able to continue that style and that momentum at MGM Records. Under Fred Foster and Wesley Rose, Roy had a lot of great joy and a lot of chart-topping songs. So when Roy signed on with MGM in 1965, fans were very surprised to see that the momentum and the style continued. So when you transfer to 1966 and you hear The Orbison Way, the sound continued on. Roy's success also continued. The first single from the album and the first track from the collection, Crawling Back, was released in late 1965, and it went on to become a good chart-topping song all over the world. Number 46 in the UK, number 2, barely making it almost to number 1 in Canada, and number 19 in Australia. In Poland, it went to number 14. It also was followed up by Breaking Up Is Breaking My Heart, another good chart-topping rock song, rock love song. Breaking Up Is Breaking My Heart went to number 31 in the US, number 22 in the UK, number 2, almost making it to number 1 in Canada. In the Netherlands, it went to number 20. So Roy's momentum on the charts with this new collection continued. And all around the world, Roy continued to pack arenas, stadiums, all different concert halls. Roy was still continuing to make his name in the world of music. So let's take a deep dive into the collection of 12 songs from The Orbison Way. As I said a moment ago, you start off with Crawling Back, Roy's first single from the album. There were two singles. The other one was Breaking Up Is Breaking My Heart. You also have then It Ain't No Big Thing, Time Changed Everything, This Is My Land, The Loner, all four ballad songs, maybe another kind of upbeat ballad song. And then you go on to Go Away, which followed up after Breaking Up Is Breaking My Heart on the album. A New Star, Never, which was another kind of bouncy tune. It Wasn't Very Long Ago, which Roy did a live updated BBC recording. In fact, here is It Wasn't Very Long Ago.
A Roy Orbison spectacular. Top of the bill star, Roy Orbison. Here's a song written for Roy by his British MD Barry Booth and titled
It Wasn't Very Long Ago I Met You, I Saw You. It wasn't very long ago you whispered I love you. Look at us now, crying our hearts out trying to remember what love was like. Although it wasn't very long ago I thrilled when I kissed you. It wasn't very long ago I cried when I missed you. Look at us now, crying in my heart trying to remember what love was like. Although wasn't very long ago.
Well, that was It Wasn't Very Long Ago. Roy spotlighted that on the BBC Radio Network when he was over there overseas touring, and he has a deep interview speaking with the gentleman who interviewed him, and he went on to say that that song was recorded by Barry Booth, and other songs performed that evening was It's Over, Twinkle Toes, which would be a later song we'll spotlight in the classic Roy Orbison, and then, of course, It's Over, which was a big hit for Roy in early 1964. And then we finish out the Orbison way with Why Hurt the Ones Who Love You. So another score-perfect album that Roy recorded from July to November of 1965, and then he had the album released in January 1966. So Roy continued, again, his momentum in Australia, England, the U.S., all over the world. Roy continued his momentum on the charts with the Orbison way. So this album collection in all of Roy's MGM years was released, remastered, officially re-released in 2015 under the MGM years box set on the Orbison.com estate. So if you have a chance to pick up this collection or any of the MGM songs and albums we're going to talk about here over the next several videos, get your hands on it, because this is, again, classic Orbison at its best in ballad and rock songs. And also, it shows a side of Roy that many fans, as Roy went on to MGM, there was a side of Roy that became less and less on the charts. Many fans did not even know that some of these songs overseas were released because they were only released in the United States. Or Roy's 1970 album called The Big O with Art Movement was only released in Australia and the UK. So a lot of songs that we're going to spotlight in the videos ahead are going to come across that you may never even heard of before. So get your hands on the Orbison MGM box set 2015 as soon as you can. You will not be sorry, folks. This is classic Roy Orbison at its best. And that's it, Orbison fans, for another episode spotlighting Roy's embodiment of rock music. Thank you so much for checking it out. If you have not done so yet, please take a moment to subscribe. And every time a new video is released or uploaded, you will receive an alert on my channel. So again, thank you so much, everyone, for the support, the comments, the requests for these album reviews to continue. Your positive comments is meaning so much to me. So thank you so much for being part of this journey. I absolutely love embodiment and spotlighting Roy's music. So thank you again so much, everybody, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.